Hi everybody, welcome back. Now, a couple of weeks ago, we were able to give the caravan a really good deep clean. We had it in mind that we were going to give the caravan a good clean, ready for a fun-packed spring and summer. None of us knew what was about to happen. Anyway, that aside, the caravan needed a clean because actually we hadn't cleaned it up since the summer of last year. And trust me, it was getting a bit grubby. In fact, we used the caravan right throughout the autumn and the winter, and every time we took it out, we just said the same thing. We really need to give this caravan a really good clean before we go out again. The caravan was filthy. And just look how bad it is. We've got the dreaded black streaks, some green moss build up in the panel joins, I've got bird muck, road traffic debris, and when I removed the awning rail protectors earlier, lots and lots of muck. Deep cleaning the caravan body doesn't need to be difficult, and we can do the bulk of this work with a few cleaning products, a long-handled brush, a clean paintbrush, a water source, and some microfiber cleaner cloths. I mentioned a water source, and we're really lucky to have a hose pipe with a dedicated wash bay. But in our previous storage yard, where no running water existed, we completed the same tasks with some garden pump sprayers and an aqua roll full of water. You will get the same results, it may take a little bit longer, and you can check out one of our very first videos, the link to that is in the description. Now up to this point, I've already cleaned the roof by using a bucket of shampoo and a long-handled stiff brush. I used exactly the same principles as our roof cleaning video, click on the link in the video description down below. The most important step here is to raise or lower the nose of the caravan to encourage as much water to run off the roof. So let's give the caravan a good soak. Use either a hose pipe or water from a pump sprayer and spray the body of the caravan to remove any large deposits that have come off the roof. Be careful not to use a high pressure washer and don't spray into any vents or seals around the caravan. While the caravan is wet, we can start the cleaning process by removing heavy contaminants such as those dreaded black streaks. My chemical weapon of choice on this occasion is Silky Deep Clean, but any strong caravan cleaner or black streak remover will work here. Spray onto the caravan or use a microfiber cloth on the heavy marks as per the product instructions. Now I really rate this Silky Deep Clean, and watch and listen to my reaction as I wipe away the black streaks.
Oh my god.
In this instance, and for this product, I wipe on, leave for 30 seconds, agitate, then rinse off to reveal a streak-free caravan surface. This product is great for removing any traffic film, insects and heavy stains, or marks such as bird muck. And I use this product also to clean up the motor movers and the alloy wheels. So now the heavy marks are removed, it's time to focus on details which sometimes get missed. So areas such as locker doors, the awning rail, and any mouldings that incur a buildup of dirt. Now for anyone who's watched my videos, they'll know I've been a fan of Silky Cream Cleaner for many years. It's what my dad used to clean the caravan back in the 80s, and it's still the same product today. So I'm using the cream cleaner with a small clean paintbrush, and I'm agitating the cream cleaner to work into the areas of the caravan that a cloth or a sponge won't reach. Here you can see I'm focusing on the grab handle, the moulding and the trim at the rear of the caravan. Now a top tip for using the cream cleaner is to apply it to a wet surface, use the product sparingly, and I can't emphasise that enough, and agitate it until the cream cleaner becomes soapy. For wider areas such as raised decals or panel joins, use the cream cleaner with a wet microfiber cloth and again use it sparingly. Once the product has been worked in, rinse down to reveal a clean, bright surface. When cleaning the awning rail, focus on the top and the bottom edge as well as the channel of the rail to make sure that any debris has been removed. Finally, it's time to clean the flat surfaces of the caravan. Use a pH neutral shampoo, which is safe to use on the delicate caravan surfaces, and dilute into a clean bucket of water. Apply the shampoo either with a sponge, a bubble mitt, or like me on this instance, a soft long handled cleaning brush. Don't use any brushes or sponges on the windows, I'll come back to the windows in a moment. Now a top tip is to split the caravan into sections and clean from the top down, allowing the dirt to run off the caravan sides. Once one panel has been cleaned, rinse down before moving on to the other panel. Now, I had to rush on this occasion, I had a few caravans and motorhomes queuing up to use the facility, so I didn't film me going around the entire caravan, but you get the idea. Now, going back to the windows, apply diluted shampoo directly to the window with your fingertips. Using your fingertips will reduce the risk of scratches, and if you do feel any grit on your fingers, you can stop immediately. So now we have a clean, wet caravan ready for the next steps. Now, because of the queue of caravans and motorhomes, I had to bring our caravan back into its storage bay. But the next step is to wipe the entire surface of the caravan down with some microfiber cloths. While the caravan continues to dry, open every window to reveal the rubbers, wipe around the windows to remove any dirt that was missed or trapped under the windows. And it's also a good time to apply some silicone spray to the rubbers to keep them clean and supple. Use an acrylic window cleaner to clean on the inside and the outside of every window to remove any fingerprints or marks. Now on the outside, open every single locker and compartment and flap on the outside of the caravan and give it a good wipe over on the inside and around the edges. If they've got a rubber seal on them, apply some silicone lubricant here as well. So now the outside of the caravan should be spotless, and it's time to protect the surface and maintain our hard work by applying a layer of fine wax. Use either a waterless spray wax or a hard wax that can be applied with a sponge. In this instance, I'm using the waterless wash and wax from Diamond Bright, and you can spray this onto the surface, then wipe down with a cloth to reveal a bright, shiny surface. And that's it, a clean, well-prepared caravan ready for the season ahead. So another job I did for the outside of the caravan, which weirdly was at home, was to take the caravan awning rail protectors out and take them home and give them a good clean. They were filthy. I mean, when I removed them, there was muck coming off of them, and I was amazed on how much muck there was on the protectors. So I took them home and I soaked them in some warm water with some detergent, wiped them down both sides, gave them a really good scrub, and as I was doing that, Angela was cleaning them, wiping them as well. So by the time we finished, they were nice and clean and ready to go back into the caravan. And to put them back in the caravan, I just sprayed the ends with some silicone spray just to help them and ease them along inside the clean awning rail channel. It's worth thinking and considering how much muck those awning rail protectors have really stopped getting into the awning rail channels. So if you're interested, well, I've put a link to those in the description down below. Right, and there we go. That's the outside of the caravan now nice and clean, ready for the season ahead, whenever that may be. All I need to do now is wipe over the caravan with some waterless wash and wax. I do that anyway when we put the towing cover on, just to make sure that no scratches and no dirt is on the surface of the caravan. But from here onwards, it's going to be easy to maintain. Maybe halfway through the season, we give the caravan another good washdown ready for the latter part of the year. So if you have any comments or questions, please do ask them down below. I'll try my very best to answer them for you. Please do subscribe to our channel. Hit the notification icon if you can do all of that. Then we'll see you next time, when we will perhaps be looking at cleaning the inside of the caravan. Anyway, till next time, guys, many thanks for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.